And traders, I am done for the day and done for the week. I'm having a good day today with several winners, four winners. Boeing was a nice winner, and also had Roku and Work and ZM, my second trade in ZM. So if you count all togethers, I've got like four winners, actually five with a second trade in ZM and three losers, my first trade in ZM. I want to talk a little bit about ZM here, and before I just go away. So anyway, I'm going to finish up over 6 grand. I still have some small size left in Roku, but that's it. So a nice green day, and that would be for a very nice green week. Although I had two losing days, just one $200, the second one unpleasant. But anyway, I'm going to finish up very nicely for the week. And just a quick note about ZM here before I go away. The first thing we noticed today is the S&P 500 and the way it started up. It started up over 2%. It's currently up approximately where it started, a little bit higher. So it started at 2, right now it's at 2.2, but as you can see, it's just going sideways. And on the other hand, you take a look at ZM. When the market is starting up 2% and ZM starting down 4%, you know that you've got a case of a stock that is under a lot of pressure today. Now, if you take a look at the daily of ZM, you can see that it moved up quite a bit recently. And then, a pullback is due, some profit taking, whatever reason, I don't care, I don't know, I don't mind. Yesterday it started coming down, today it continued with a gap down. So you expect it to be under some pressure, and anyway, it is definitely under a pressure. It started down 4%. Try to move lower than higher than I shorted it here, which I should, because that's a classic gap and go, which did not work out. So a stop loss over the high somewhere. I can't remember exactly where it was. Anyway, I was still waiting for ZM. The reason why I was still waiting for ZM, because the stock is down 4%, maybe a bit less, 3% after it moved higher. And then you look, you keep watching. It doesn't matter if you have a losing trade in a stock that you failed earlier. You keep watching for a sign of a failure. And my sign of a failure was right over here, or at 202.50. I posted it again for a short. Now, it's not very, very clear. I mean, it does look nice. It failed to move higher. That's one of the signs you're seeing here is how it failed to move higher, came back down. Doesn't mean much because it could continue moving higher. Now it's trying to move to a new high, failing again. Now here comes the point where you start thinking, well, if it's going to come down under 202.50, it may just continue. That's where I posted it for my second trade. And look at how beautiful that turned out to be. But you need also to take a look at the S&P at around the same time, because the S&P seemed like it may be losing it. It came all the way from the highs back to the lows. So you may think that the S&P is under pressure. But the thing is, when you have the S&P coming down, stocks should follow. Most of the stocks, if you're going to take a look at almost everything, like Roku, we also had a nice trade in Roku. It also came down at around the same time. We had the same short in Roku. But a stock that is already under pressure, like Roku, like ZM, at the same time when the market's coming down, when it is already under pressure, the pressure is much stronger in those which are lagging. Like if ZM's down 3 or 4%, it's going to come down stronger than anything else. Roku was red at that point. Now remember again, the market's up 2.2%, that Roku is red. I don't care that it moved higher and was green for a while. It is under pressure. It has more sellers than buyers today. Definitely more pressure. So you look at a stock that is relatively weak, you're not messing up with those which are extremely strong, although I was lucky today with Boeing. I can't say it any other way. Oh, Boeing just moved to a new high. I posted the trade over 205. I missed it. It just did it. Anyway, I was probably lucky with Boeing. That's the only thing I can say. But if you want to short something, you concentrate on shorts, on stocks that are, again, relatively to the market, are weaker than the market. I said it several times, I'm going to say it once more. If you pick up a fight in the bar, Don't pick up the bully in the bar. Don't pick up the one who looks strong. Pick up something. If you gotta have a fight, pick up something that looks like you can win. So ZM is one you can win. Roku is one that certainly looks like you could win. So, you know, mess around with stocks that are already down, that are looking weak. The market comes down, they will be under more pressure. Look for them and short them. You probably have more, it's more likely to succeed. And it did succeed. Roku, ZM, and my account says so, over $6,000 today. That's it, traders. I really had a good week, although I had, like, again, the 2 days where I was red, one was just $200, but you know, I still have it, I'm still feeling like I had a tough week for some reason. The rest was a perfect week, so I really enjoyed it. And anyway, glad we could have traded together today and had some fun, and enjoy the rest of your day and your weekend. Really enjoyed being with you. Thank you all for being with me, with us. And you guys on YouTube, if you don't mind giving us a thumb up, that would be extremely helpful for our channel. We'll appreciate that. And I'm looking forward to see you next week. And we do have the Star Trader course next week, so we'll be seeing each other a bit more than usual. Thank you all. Have a great weekend. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. The material was taken from The Market Whisperer, my Amazon best-selling book. This essential guide to stock trading is ideal for those with no background or experience in stock trading. Click here to read the 200-page part 1 of this book absolutely free. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.